Oh, hey, I didn't see you there. I was just wondering, why does Grays Lake have an airport? How, when, and why did Campbell Airport get there?
The story begins with a man named Vern Campbell. He invented Campbell caps, which are the fabric coverings available for snowblowers to keep the operator dry. Well, with the money from his invention and business, he bought the land that would soon become Campbell Airport.
I bet you didn't see me there. Mr. Campbell built runways on his farmland, and in 1956, it was certified as a personal airport. But then, in 1962, it was approved by the FAA as a publicly available commercial airport, with its current runways completed in 1964.
A key event in Campbell's history came in 1973, when the village of Grays Lake created plans to buy and expand the airport to include a 5,500-foot runway. The plans were approved by the FAA, but unfortunately, Grays Lake never bought the airport, and it fell into the hands of the Empire. I mean, Round Lake Park.
Currently, it is a publicly owned and operated airport. Anyone flying through can stop by for fuel or stay the night. If you live in the area, you can keep your airplane there, get it maintained there, or even get some flying lessons from the Cardinal Aircraft Services. At any time, you might find up to 80 private aircraft stored in Campbell's 3 hangars and on the flight line.
To get some background on the airport's past popularity, we interviewed Charlotte K. Renahan of the Grays Lake Historical Society. She told us that the airport used to be busier, with parachuting and model plane flying. Nowadays, it's just used by private plane hobbyists. In review, we set out to answer the question, how, when, and why did Campbell Airport get there?
Well, it all started with Vern Campbell's snowblower accessory business.
He turned a piece of farmland to a private airport
to a public airport that could have been central to the history of Grays Lake.
But that was an opportunity that just flew away.
And that's Campbell Airport for you, kids.